Good evening. Thank you so much for being with us tonight as we present our choral celebration. These students have worked extremely hard over the past few weeks to prepare for this, in addition to preparing for show choir season and concert choir and Traces of Blue, all the things that they've done, the superior ratings that they've already earned this year and grand championships. So we're very proud of the students. Thank you, parents, for always supporting us and doing everything we need to be successful. I'd like to thank First Baptist Church, Dr. Philip Cooper, Brother Philip Butler, Marilyn Summerall, and Jeremy Thompson for allowing us to come in. We take over for about 3 days, and they're always so willing and gracious to host us so we can have this performance, and we appreciate them. Tonight we'll be accompanied by Lynn Butler and June Harrison, who have accompanied us several years, and we appreciate them so much. And also we have three high school students that will be performing with us in various pieces, Marty Hinchy, Oren King, and Braden Dupree, and we appreciate them. We have a student teacher this semester who has done an exceptional job. That's Mr. Jonathan Dixon, and we wish him the best. He'll be conducting tonight. We know he has a bright future and career ahead of him. And also Susan Albert, who is the choral music assistant here, who is behind the scenes making sure all of this happens. We truly appreciate her. Tonight, our administrators are our narrators, and we are excited to have Dr. Stephen Hampton, our superintendent of education, Lamar County Schools, and Ms. Jenny Henschling, our school board member for the Summerall Zone, with us. Let's welcome them tonight. And we appreciate all the support that they give our program. They are truly going above and beyond to make sure that we are successful in everything we do. Each year since we began this, we combined with the Summerall Food Pantry to provide something for Christmas, and this year it was pie fillings. And so I'm going to ask Gloria Gerritsen, the coordinator, to come speak to you for a minute about that ministry.
Thank you so much. I am so happy to be here once again and kind of update you on the food pantry. We've had a kind of a rough several few years here with the pandemic, and now with the economic situation, we're really seeing an uptick in the needs in the community. We are even seeing some homeless people coming through. This year, I've been sweating really hard trying to find food because FeedAmerica.org has not had very much food and has not had meat for over 6 months. And all of a sudden the other day, I saw it on the order and I ordered everything I could. So we're in good shape for the meat for the distribution on the 21st. What we lack is something happy, like pie fillings, something like that, that we can put in those sacks. So every pie filling that you bring will be used. We are looking at over 270 sacks that we're going to have to fill this time. Last January, we had 229. We're up to 224 in November. And then we've given out 8 or 10 since that time. So in the next 2 weeks, we'll be giving out 270. Thank you so much, all of you guys that bring the pie filling. And thank you for listening to me. Thanks.
Thank you again for joining us, and we hope you have a Merry Christmas and enjoy the show.
Christmas, that outrageous season of tinsel, gift wrapping, parties, cheesy movies, and far too much chocolate. A time where the normal rules of life just don't seem to apply. Families gather and children lose themselves in the excitement.
Christmas, the season of joy. And what better way to express joy than through singing? Nothing warms the heart more than a familiar carol and songs of the season.
Some describe the beauty of sparkling winter nights, snow, tinsel, and twinkling lights.
Some celebrate the joy of giving and receiving gifts, or of simply gathering around the fire to bask in the warmth of friendship and love.
Tonight, we will celebrate in song. We sing of love and hope and peace, and especially joy.
Oh, no.
History's most powerful yet forgotten Christmas stories. It took place in the improbable setting of the mud, cold rain, and senseless killing in the trenches of World War I. It happened in spite of orders to the contrary by superiors. It happened in spite of language barriers. And it still stands as the only time in history that peace spontaneously arose from the lower ranks in a major conflict, bubbling up to the officers and temporarily turning sworn enemies into friends.
It began when German soldiers lit candles on small Christmas trees, and British, French, Belgian, and German troops serenaded each other on Christmas Eve. Soon they were gathering and burying the dead in an age-old custom of truces. But as the power of Christmas grew among them, they broke bread, exchanged addresses and letters, and expressed deep admiration for one another. When the angry superiors ordered them to recommence them the shooting, many men aimed harmlessly high overhead.
Sometimes the greatest beauty emerges from deep tragedy. Surely the forgotten Christmas truce was one of history's most beautiful moments, made all the more beautiful in light of the carnage that would follow it.
All is calm, all is bright, round.
singing Joy to the World.
Thank you.
words of that song at Christmas time is comforting to many. But some people are unable to absorb that message because their lives are in turmoil. They've experienced the loss of a loved one, a serious illness, or depression that will not go away. Their hearts loudly cry out, "All is not well, not for me." Despite the dark night of the soul we may experience, all is well because of the promise of the season.
Thank you.
those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Cornelius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. There were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. But an angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and laying in the manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, goodwill to men." When the angels had left and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about the child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had to say to them. But Mary treasured all of these things in her heart and pondered them. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Thank you.
friendship that brightens all the year. It's thoughtfulness and kindness. It's hope reborn again. For peace, for understanding, for goodwill to men.
God bless and Merry Christmas.